Fellow Ugandans, ladies and gentlemen, I am Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, also known as Bobi Wine, Member of Parliament for Kyadondo East Constituency, and also your comrade in the struggle for a free Uganda. I come to you today to address you on the issue of the high taxes that President Museveni's government continues to impose on the citizens of this nation. On Wednesday, the 11th day of July 2018, joined by patriotic young men and women of Uganda, we marched in Kampala City in protest against the unfair and extortionist mobile money and social media taxes. Our march was very peaceful until some officers from the Uganda Police Force disrupted it using tear gas and live bullets on the peaceful demonstrators. Our comrades were arrested and jailed, but I know that not even jail can shut the mouths of oppressed citizens. This happened despite the fact that we had notified the police of our intended protest as required by law. I commend all Ugandans from all walks of life who joined us in this protest and all those who led demonstrations countrywide. I also acknowledge the messages of support and solidarity which we continue to receive from all corners of Uganda and the world over. Let me be clear that we are peaceful Ugandans exercising our constitutional right to freely assemble and demonstrate. This is our country. This is our home. So why are we protesting? We are protesting against the taxes which continue to make citizens of Uganda slaves in their own country. We protest because we have been turned into beasts of burden. Ugandans work very hard and all the government does is to milk the last penny out of them. Instead of giving incentives to the unemployed young Ugandans to make startups like in other countries, the government is simply making life impossible for them. We protest because as we speak, government continues to put hardworking Ugandans in a corner and to squeeze life out of them. Yes, as we speak, the taxes on fuels and other basic commodities have forced the prices to skyrocket. We protest because the citizens of this country pay and pay through the nose, but do not get the services that they deserve. All our sweat and labor is abused. A lot of our money is either wasted or stolen. The common citizen's effort goes to satisfy the lavish lifestyle of very few people. This is why we protest. As Ugandans pay, hospitals continue to rot, our mothers continue to die while giving birth, and yes, our children continue to study under terrible conditions. Unemployment continues to rise, and the gap between the rich and the poor continues to grow. The more we are forced to pay, is the more government says it does not have enough money and it keeps borrowing debts which our children and their children will have to pay. This is why we protest. We know how shameless our government is, that while citizens are still groaning under the yoke of heavy taxation, President Museveni has directed the Minister of Finance to urgently avail money for the 456 members of Parliament. And this is expected to cost the taxpayer more than 290 billion shillings. The citizen of this nation has been mocked enough. This provocation of Ugandans needs to stop. We cannot continue to be taken for granted. We can't continue to be taken for a ride. We reject the double taxation and the triple taxation with the contempt that they deserve. Who on earth came up with this ridiculous idea of taxing social media? How can they say that social media is a luxury when most of our unemployed youth rely on social media as a source of livelihood? The government just doesn't understand our hustle. Time is now for us to realize that we are on our own. And yes, it is now time for us to fight for ourselves before it is too late. Since we started these campaigns, we have noted that government has accepted to review the taxes. We call upon all of you to join us in saying this tax must go. This is evidence that if we unite and speak with one voice, there is nothing that we cannot achieve. Now, our voices need to get louder and more assertive and more emphatic. When called upon, please join us in our next peaceful protest. This is a cause for our nation. Let us join hands as citizens and reject exploitation. I particularly call upon young people of Uganda, lawyers, doctors, journalists, economists, entertainers, business people, farmers, border, taxi riders, religious leaders, all people of Uganda, please join this cause because it is a noble cause. We repeat our message to our brothers and sisters who serve in the security forces. We are not fighting you. We are fighting for you. And always remember, people power, our power. Our power, people power.